Sin City was a maybe, angels like you.
I too was in relationships with girls, so what I did was I hid myself for a long time. So I'm trying not to tear up. it wasn't until the pandemic when I came out to my
I think black guy kind of sus. I think this guy kind of sus, bro. I think he kind of straight. How y'all messing with the new face cam?
Sin City was a maybe, angels like you.
Let me stop real quick. But what are we gonna do today? It's gonna be a little reaction video. You feel me? A little reaction video. So it's gonna right there. 5 gay men versus 1 secret straight guy. We gotta guess who the. I think we gotta guess who the straight guy is. So yeah, that's what we're gonna do.
I'm gay.
All right. So one of them is not gay. One of them is not gay.
It was probably Clay. Like end of high school after my first relationship.
Wait. What did he say? Wait, hold on. I didn't.
When did everyone realize they were gay?
Probably.
What did he say?
When did everyone realize they were gay?
My fault.
Probably. Like end of high school after my first relationship, it was a girl and it was just not for me.
I think for me it was in middle school. It was like before puberty, so I was just kind of figuring things out for myself, and also other kids were understanding too, so that really helped me to find myself when I would talk about it.
15.
Oh,
so I know exactly when it was. I grew up in a very religious home, and I too was in relationships with girls. So what I did was I hid myself for a long time. So I'm trying not to tear up. it wasn't until the pandemic when I came out to my little brother.
I actually knew when I was 8. My grandma took me to see Mamma Mia, and if you've seen the movie, you know the beach scene. You know exactly what I'm talking about. And I knew something was just a little bit off about
all right,
me
I think,
when I realized
I think,
that
all
I
right,
was.
I think black guy kind of sus. I think this guy kind of sus, bro. I think he kind of straight. I ain't gonna
little
lie.
Brother.
And if you've seen the movie, you know the beach scene. You know exactly what I'm talking about. And I knew something was just a little bit off about me when I realized that I was more attracted to Sky than I was Sophie. I'm like, something about him.
You know, mine honestly is right after Twilight came out. Robert Pattinson, I don't know.
So yo, good. Who's team? Who's team?
So good. Of course. Pattinson for sure. Edward.
I knew in middle school, like, there was something up with me. I was like, I like men. That's 100%. But I called myself bisexual. And then freshman year in high school, I was just like, I'm gay. Like, the way I feel about women is nothing like the way I feel about men.
Okay. I already revealed mine, but what is everyone's
favorite celebrity crush? Bro, it gotta be the
black guy.
Mine is also a vampire. It's Paul Wesley from Vampire Diaries. He was like my gay awakening, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, well, mine was Robert Pattinson, so I'm the vampire.
Yeah, we got.
I do not know who these people are.
Something about that man.
I do not know who these people are.
Ooh, just. I just love Ross Lynch. Yeah.
Prince and Idris Elba.
Mine right now, I think, is Pedro Pascal.
You're on the Pedro Pascal
he's
train.
Yeah.
I don't know who's gay anymore after he just
Matt
said
Bomber,
that.
Matt Bomer from White Collar. Love, like, the snake eyes are so sexy. Like, that's it.
What do you guys hate about straight men?
Their inability to, like, take criticism or take no as an answer.
Yeah.
Like, what is up with that? Like, I understand patriarchy and all that, but still.
I know, like, consent.
Literally.
Their inability to have any sort of fashion. It's just t-shirts.
Just about to
and
say
jeans.
That.
T-shirts, jeans, or, like, just basketball shorts.
You know, you see those men who clearly use like the 3-in-1 shampoos, and I'm just like,
oh my gosh,
how?
They brush their teeth with it.
Yeah, like I swear.
Oh my god, this literally. One guy had a 10-in-1. I did not even want to ask what it meant.
Hold the fuck on right now. I know I'm not.
Lucifer, I just wanted to ask you, so you said at 15 is when you knew, right? That you were gay?
Yes, that's when I came to terms with it for myself.
And then you said, during COVID was when you told your brother?
Yes.
So that whole time he didn't know?
No.
Really, how did that feel for you? Because were you guys close, or?
We were, but I moved from Memphis when I was 18.
Okay.
We've been long distance for all that time.
I see.
He really didn't make a big deal out of it, just told me that he loved me no matter what.
I see. Well, can I ask why did you not come out to him earlier if you guys felt so comfortable together with that? Or
yes.
Supportive?
Yes. So for me, when I was growing up, the thing that mattered most was getting married and having a family. I had to keep that facade a long time. I was actually practicing to be a minister in 2012,
oh, wow.
Right when President Obama declared gay marriage legalized nationwide. And when I was in
the- I don't know what they're talking about.
I want to hear more.
Hey, have you spotted the mole yet? Well, hang tight because we're going to get there.
All I think
until then,
is the black
subscribe
guy.
To our
it gotta
channel.
Be the black guy.
And now let's get back
that's
to the
That's the
video.
Only one that seems sus to me. The black guy. That's it.
That tank top that he's wearing is really tacky.
Sorry, just the jeans and his shirt.
Good luck, guys. It kind of hurted a little bit. Kind of hurted.
Why do you think they were suspicious of you?
I feel like Justin was gay. I feel like he was gay.
But I look stylish and I look amazing. So.
Lucifer, I remember you were mentioning that like gay marriage was being legalized in 2012, but it was 2015, right?
2013. Yeah.
No, but the black guy might be gay though, yeah, so I don't know.
Yeah, because it was. I remember it precisely. I was on the phone with my pastor, actually, when that announcement was made.
He was running in 2012, so yeah, he
right,
would have.
Right.
So 15? 16? I'm bad at math.
I'm terrible.
Well, it took a while for it to actually go into legislation.
Gotcha.
So you can say 2012, but if you're technically, yes, it did take a few years into that second term before it was actually registered. What are some things you looked for in a guy?
Oh, creativity.
Okay, I don't feel like it's a black guy no more.
And confidence.
Number one would be hygiene.
Yeah.
Mm. I bathe at least twice a day, if, you know, not more.
We're in a drought.
So,
not anymore.
Baby, please, look, you know, I gotta freshen up. So I expect that from someone else.
I don't think it's a black guy anymore.
Yeah, my boyfriend, every time or my ex-boyfriend.
Oh, no.
Yeah, every time I'd come in, like, the room is just super messy. And, like, I'm really big on bathroom cleanliness.
Mm.
Yes. It's the last place you are at night and the first place you are in the morning.
Exactly.
And most traditional men are just dirty in the bathrooms.
Right.
For me, definitely funny. And, I mean, obviously, you have to look good. Like, that's yeah, that's a non-starter, though. Mine is basically somebody that could just hang and vibe with me. I'm a very active person, whether that be, like, I'm going out hiking, I go out working out. Height doesn't really matter. I mean, haven't found anybody as tall as me yet.
How are you?
6'6".
Okay.
Damn!
6'2", but I have these on right now, so a little bit taller.
I love those, by the way.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, they're brand cool. New, they're Doc Martens.
Me too.
Look at.
I love Docs.
These are the brand new model. They have little
yeah,
hooks.
Yeah, I know. I saw those.
Oh,
I saw
so
those.
Cool.
Did you miss the memo that we were supposed to wear boots today?
Yes.
Yeah, I did.
You know,
I do prefer men that are shorter than me, a little more on the submissive side.
We're out.
I hate the bottom.
Oh.
I'm just being honest. I guess because I was in such a controlled environment for so many years.
I don't know who it is.
Of controlling that space.
Okay. Can we run down and say what we are? Like, you already answered.
Yes.
We'll say bottom.
Top. Or verse. Top verse.
I say I'm a verse top.
Yeah. Verse bottom.
He's definitely a bottom. Ricky is a bottom for sure. Did you see what this man is wearing? Had the mid-drift and all.
Yeah, it just takes the right person for me.
Yeah, I agree. I think it's very dependent. But honestly, like, the verse comes in more so when it's with, like, hookups and stuff like that.
All right,
baby,
let's...
I'm a Scorpio,
all right,
so,
wait.
Like...
Me too!
Who could be it? Like... I don't think it's a black guy no more, and I don't know who it is still, so I have no clue. They all seem gay to me. They all seem gay to me. I have no clue.
Oh, nice. So nice.
Wait. Yeah, nah. That nigga straight. Hell no. A gay nigga doesn't.
I dapped up Lucifer.
That was straight.
That felt very hetero to me. Ew.
That was straight.
Oh, and my other thing, if they're open to threesomes, because I want to do that. Hey, say.
To the camera.
He's looking. If you're out there and you're open to threesomes, Lucifer is available. Right.
I think it's better on paper. I just want to break the truth.
Chill out, bro.
Really?
Chill out.
Because it's just like it's just another person. It just gets a lot. I don't know. Is. I just feel like
I completely agree. It's more of a novelty for sure.
Is it like a lot of just sitting around? Or
sitting around? Just one person. When's my turn, guys?
No, it's like
I don't know what they're talking about.
It's like great.
Let's do a round of smash or pass.
Dominic Fike.
Smash. Michael B. Jordan.
Smash.
Ooh, Creed 3.
Oh my god.
Creed 3. The Rock.
Smash.
What?
No. Fred Big. Yes.
I'm so sorry.
Oh my god.
Wait, that's so surprising to me because you said that you were a top, like you like being in control. Dude, The Rock?
Yeah. Okay. I can take him.
He might be a super shorter than you.
Really. I can take wait.
But
Rock
I mean,
is huge.
I've been watching wrestling.
He's
for
definitely
a long time
he's too. Definitely gay, bro. It gotta be him. It gotta be the guy with the blue shirt. Yeah, it's Matt. I feel it's Matt.
Topping The Rock. Come on.
That's sus.
Yeah,
that's
I thought ugly. It was Lucifer too, but I don't think it's Lucifer. I think it's Matt now. Oh, they voted him out.
Good luck, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Let's all screw up again.
Oh, they bitches. They jealous. They see I'm totally star power. They just didn't want to share the money with me. I'm not someone that gets offended easily, but bitch, that offended me. I am offended.
Damn.
This is the shit I'm talking about.
I knew he was gay. I knew he was gay.
Look at me. What? Do I look straight to you?
You look gay.
You want to continue playing because you think that there's potentially still a liar among the four of you in the box? Raise your hand on three, all right? One, two, three.
Wait, raise your hand and just continue playing?
Yes.
I'm not sure.
So you four I think it's Matt.
I think it's Matt. I think it's Matt. That's all I gotta say.
I can unconfidently say.
Yeah. He's like my besties right here.
Besties. So that means the game has ended. The box turns green, you have correctly voted the mole out, and you four will share a cash prize. If the box turns red, that means the mole is still among you four, and they win the cash prize themselves.
Alright, bet.
Are you guys ready?
I think the the straight dude's mad, bro. The straight dude's mad. It's gonna turn red. Yeah, I knew it, yeah!
I was unconfident. I
knew it was Matt.
Why would I act surprised? This is one of you aren't my besties.
All right.
It's Matt.
So the mole has won.
That dap up was just no.
And on the count of three, I'm gonna have the mole step forward. One, two, three.
Why'd y'all all step forward?
What?
We're all the moles.
Wait, all of them are straight. Wait, what?
Look at us. We are besties after all.
I was very confused.
I was like, you had me with the fit, Ricky.
For real?
Honestly, yes.
Dude, this is my girlfriend's tea.
I took a step. And I was like, are these people stupid? Like, why is everyone else stepping
right?
Up? Like, I'm only straight. Dude, y'all are gay.
I thought that everyone was
I thought gay. All of them. I thought most of them were gay, bro.
Yes. For a long time.
I know. Every night I feel like when I go out with my friends or whatever, I get hit on by more guys than girls.
Okay, now that was a plot twist. I ain't gonna lie.
Yeah. I got mistaken for being gay a lot of the time. I'll be honest, I went on dates with guys because so many people were suspecting me of it, but I was just like, that's not me. After being on those dates, I was like, I like women. That's a fact.
My story that I was telling was very genuine. I'd suppressed my alternative to being macho straight for a long time because I just don't fit the mold for the typical straight guy. There's always questions of, is he or isn't he?
Fucking hell, dude.
I've been training for this for a week.
How did you train for it?
Bro, I FaceTimed all my gay homies. They were saying like, I'm gonna be a verse top because that's like the least bro. Sus, but it's also gay. Dude, I practiced walking, I practiced my fits. I was doing like 360.
That's crazy. You training to act like a gay nigga?
60 Snapchat videos, like, damn, do I look gay or not? Like, does my ass pop?
I work at
Bro,
Urban
what?
There's a lot of gay men. He helped me pick up this nail polish.
I called all my gay friends, and I watched, like, a whole bunch of drag. I watched so much drag, bro. Like, and it's actually really good.
It's like so y'all trying to turn into like a gay man.
I think my game plan was to just not offend anybody. I stuck to that. Because I'm very inclusive.
I applied for this episode because, especially right now with the whole red pill movement, Aiden Ross, Andrew Tate, the toxic male influences out there, that it's very important to show like other men and especially younger men that are coming up into this world that it is okay to be feminine. Is it okay to express your emotions? Is it okay to be vulnerable?
Accept everyone. It doesn't matter what your looks, sexuality, gender are. Just accept everyone.
I thought most of them were gay.
And don't be mad if you're not as confident as the people who are.
Like, not jumping to conclusions.
See, I started to get offended when they started talking about the straight guy. I started to get offended when they started talking about us. But turns out, all of them niggas were straight. All of them.
And not, like, stereotyping anyone. Letting them speak for themselves. Yeah.
I changed my locks from you to a dude as well, bro. This is my homie Nick.
That was crazy.